Good morning. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about matter and control of matter. Now, since many years, there is a Degas painting, and the Degas painting in association with me, particularly. So, with each moment a person passes by the Degas painting, are they saying to themselves, this person is looking, this is a fat dancer? And so here I am plagued with already the phenomenon of the giving of, you are looking at a Degas dancer on the other side. I'm like, okay, so I'm Degas dancer. So if I'm the Degas dancer, is it fair? Is it fair? Because the persons on the other are out there with the critique every day as a passerby. You know, they're giving the critique, the phenomenon critique to me, again and again. She looks fat, she looks okay, why isn't she dancing? She's just standing there in the wings. What's wrong with her? You know what I mean? And so there. And then I think also past. Let's go into matter much further. Let's take matter a little bit further. Let's say, okay, they're going to adjust the painting. They're going to fix the painting. They're putting on, what are they going to put? They put a glaze on her or something. A fattener. They have the fatteners. I'm not kidding. They have the fatteners in the paint. So they put the fatteners in the paint. And so here's the Degas. And she's like, oh, this is one of those days. And so it's, but this is me because of association with I can't help it. Nobody can help it. You can all spit it out that I'm not the associate of, but you know I am. You all know I am. So, yeah. So there is a fattener now. The artist, the new artist, who is applying because maybe she's cracking or something. And so then on the days that she's cracking, here I'm having like this spaz neurosis attack. And I was like, Jesus Christ, can we fix her? Can we fix her? You know, so we apply some smoothant onto the painting. You know, so it becomes like Dorian Gray, but the Dorian Degas. Mrs. Degas in the place of, you know. It's like, uh-oh, you know. So which passerbys are walking by right now and having the humiliant critique on me? You know what I mean? The critique on me. All of this, you know. And then so there. So what else am I going to say? I'm noting already with matter itself, like here's this butterfly farm, and when it was cut, for many days, I could not film it, I could not capture it. It is a hot spot. It's almost like the earth itself is bleeding. The earth itself, it had been there for many are brand new, 3 years, some are old, 5 years, trees, and woven together. And over the many years, I'm thinking, what happened? Through that aggravation, through that event, it became a hot spot, really a hot spot, where the light energy from the planet was extra. And I can't give you an absolute as to why, just a hurt, just almost like a bleeding earth moment. Like the planet itself has decided to bleed. Now, when we have that action, we're talking hot. We're talking really hot. Like the planet has just exploded with a phenomenon event. A very bad energy. So this is the problem with what do we call it, coupage, anything that's the cut, any kind of a cutting event of the planet itself. So I'm believing from this moment, whether it's we're experiencing extra because of all this nuclear activity that's just frothing around, I'm believing at this moment that there is an attraction energy to the cut, to the actual pain, to the actual bleeding earth moment, the bleeding planet, the trees that are part of the earth. And so here it is happening, and it's just like its own way of bleeding, its own way. And in its way, it has an extravagant light. Extravagant light extra, that is not filmable, not filmable. Not till many days after, until the trees dry out. Not filmable at all. So yeah. I just thought I'd tap that in also. So I'm doomed. I'm doomed. So I'm really at the mercy. You know, I can place it at, I'm at the mercy of these artists of the Dega right now. Whoever, wherever she is, and why am I stuck here? Did they put, I'm stuck here in this house so long. Did they put the Dega? Did they put the Dega in some old stodgy museum and she cannot be free? I mean, what's the deal? Can you please put her on a tour? Put the Dega on tour, because then maybe I can get the heck out of this house, you know what I mean? Maybe I can get out of here, you know? Maybe there is some kind of a parallel life. Just by association, you know? Yeah, so there's the build of the person's minds in association, and then there's the build of, well, you know, just you know, wow. You know, we are more powerful than we think, you know, and together, it's just what we're thinking. You know, if we're all thinking, you know, she's a Dega dancer, well, great, thanks a heck of a lot. It's almost impossible for me to ever, ever, ever lose weight. It's almost impossible. So now what, you stranded me in a room somewhere because I'm not the tiny one in the front? Is this what happened? You put me in a room somewhere? Did you put me in exposure light? Am I in extra exposure light? Perhaps I'm in the museum right now and the light is so bright. The light is so destiny bright that it's impossible. It's even impossible to even see the painting. It's just like a blah, you know what I mean? So maybe that's what's been going on for years. Maybe that's what's been going on. Can you prove it, everyone? And I say, don't get an ego or anything, but can you prove it? That would be an interesting proof in the chaos. Why her? Why is she the Dega dancer? And why does she have this kind of power? And why does a painting have a power over her? She doesn't have power at all. It's almost as if the painting itself and the critique of the people and the artist who's putting on the fatteners to seal the cracks of her, those separation moments. Trennung is separation in German. It's a kind of a neat word I just discovered. So there it is, a separation moment. And so there's the artist trying to fix the separation moment, but here he is just fattening me up, you know what I mean? So that's not fair, because that's just going to fatten me up all through my lifetime, you know what I mean? All through my life. Because the painting is just going to keep cracking. Is there any way that you can put the painting tighter and compress it? You know, can we compress her? Because that's garbage. That's a garbage event. If that's my affiliation, with people and the control over their matter over me, you know, that's just a garbage event. Because it seems like I'm just going to be forever doomed. I'm going to be forever doomed there's another one, and there's another one, and we'll seal it in a fattener. There is impossible. Come on. All I barely do is I drink a little bit of the wine, and I have a little bit of bread each day. This is garbage. This is garbage. Would you stop it? Can you put the painting back together again? You know what I mean? Put it back together again and stop fattening her. The same goes for photos. Any type of photos that you've ever been in, any human being out there, been in a photo, those things stretch, they expand. And so here you are in your life, and you're like 80 years old, and going, I'm such a fatso. Yeah, because your little photo when you were a little child turned into a fatso. All of these things expand through life, you know what I mean? So there's your addition into, what are we talking, the soul creepers? No, the... You know, never take my photo. Those guys, those sweethearts in their agony. Never take my photo. Not ever. not for one moment, because you're going to steal my soul. Well, eventually it is. It becomes like a vent of the cracking, the cracking and the expansion of it, and the people's perception of you as you are getting fatter. You know what I'm saying? You know, you look like this one, and so there, now you're looking fatter. And gosh dang it. Gosh dang it. Yeah. Gosh dang it. So, well, on the other side. Yeah, I know. She looks already, the Dega one, she already is a kind of a not the most thin. And I'm like, well, thanks a lot, you know, another token to the redheads. I don't think that's helpful. Another token to the redheads, another not thin dancer. Oh my gosh. What's the deal? It's almost like you're born a redhead and you're female in this life. You're just destined in. You're just destined into the life of purgatory. Of a purgatory. You're A, you have to be like a vomiter, some bulimic out there every 5 minutes after a meal. Or you have to just be like, I don't know, just brain dead puppet and just be abstinence all the time. Go, oh, I'm enjoying my life. And without fainting, dead. And so there's the one who talks, and here she is. And now the one who talks, oh my gosh, she actually ate a meal. She actually ate a meal. Anyway, these ribbons, this elastic is too fat. If anybody was curious. It's good for the back elastic people if they only want it on the back, but not in the crisscross. Gosh dang it. That's too ridiculous. Now I have overdone elastic. Who can I call? Who can I call? Overdone elastic busters. There is nobody. So anyway, so yeah, so we're talking about that conundrum moment of where is she? Where is the Dega? Where is the Dega right now? Where is that bastard goddamn painting of the woman in green? Because she is causing me some problems. She's been causing me problems my whole life. And those artists also. I want her not spread out any longer. Please, let's try to, if any little fine hairline cracks are in there, stop putting fatteners and plasticizers on her. Can you actually put something that paints her back together again? And, gosh, I don't know how it's done. How the heck can you shrink the paintings? How can we shrink the paintings back to the original? Because in this life, you know, if I'm born again into another life, I'll even be a fatter redhead. Do you understand? So it's almost like, this is, just forget it, because of the Dega painting original. I'll just become fatter. So there's no chance for me to dance in the next life, and I have to sing the opera. Opera is really difficult. It's a lot of words. It's a lot of words. Don't you understand? It's very difficult. It's a different switch for my brain. All of a sudden going to opera. I got a few words, but there's no way I could learn an entire opera. Gosh dang it. Freaks me out. But yeah, the earth is bleeding, and it's an evidence moment. The earth is bleeding out there when they were cut, when the little butterfly trees were cut. So, yeah. What more can I say? What more can I say? I don't know. That's enough for today, right, everybody? I don't know. My shoulder's still kind of busted. I don't know how to fix it. I Don't use a saw if you're a female. Don't use a saw. Just don't use a saw. They're deadly, deadly items. I have no idea how deadly until I use the saw. The Stanley saw, one of those big ones. Don't use them. They're very bad on the joint. I pulled it out so bad that I think I have an extra long arm. So, all right, everybody.